Hi guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mait, and today we're gonna talk about everything you need to know about RV tires for towable units, how to maintain them, all the different things that you might need to keep in your back pocket. Probably the two most important things that you need to know. One, check your tire pressure before you go camping. Two, have your bearings packed every year, usually. A couple of the details are this. One, before you unhook from your trailer, make sure you block your tire with something, because as soon as you disconnect from your truck, this guy is rolling. So if you're on a hill, make sure you have something to block the tires. A lot of guys will use a chalk block or even just a rock or a piece of wood or something like that, big enough to stop 10,000 pounds from rolling backwards. Another thing that you can use for that is something like this, a wheel stop. Cool thing about this is definitely big enough and it will fit right in between here. And then you can just basically tighten this guy down and it will stop the wheels from moving. It stabilizes your coach a little bit better, and it will, if you're a little bit high or raised up on this side because you're on uneven ground, you're gonna need a huge block or something to block this wheel to make sure it doesn't go backwards. But with this, that solves that problem. So then you also don't have to worry about a kid coming in and messing with your tires and your blocks and stuff like that and getting hurt. The number one thing people have that go wrong on their campers is tire blowouts. And one, the RV industry in general doesn't use that great of tires on campers. But two, it's not even because of that, it's usually because of low tire pressure. So you can either use this digital one that I have here that we have in our parts store, or even just a little manual one, and just something to check your tire pressure. Now, depending on the load range of the tire, what ply it is, and things like that, you can look on here and it'll tell you what tire pressure you want. Sometimes it'll also be on a sticker on the front. So let me show you what that sticker looks like. So just about every camper out there usually has a little tire sticker on the, let's see, this would be the driver's side. And this will usually have the weight of the camper, the GVWR, things like that. And this tire and loading information, if you can see here, it says 80 PSI. So that's what you want to fill the tire up to, is 80 PSI. It'll also usually say that on the tire as well. Another sticker that every camper will probably have if it hasn't fallen off yet is this little notice right here. So it says, check wheel lug nuts prior to each trip, only using a torque wrench. Let's see, tighten each lug nut to the manufacturer's specifications. This says 100 feet pounds or as noted. So this guy is a torque wrench. So there's a little thing that you can turn down here. Usually you want to have this turned all the way down on a torque wrench when you're not using it, so that it doesn't have those springs inside there loaded, and that way it doesn't break on you. But yeah, so read this. It's usually right around 90, 110, 119 torque, and that will change depending on what kind of tire it is. A lot of times your aluminum rims are gonna be a little bit lighter, so maybe closer to that 100 mark. A lot of times your steel wheels, and that if they're bigger, they're gonna be maybe 100, 120. So look that up before you go off that. Set your torque wrench to the correct specifications. And another reason why that's important is because a lot of times the caps on these, or the lug nuts, they call it an acorn cap, it's basically an aluminum cap over there that's fairly soft. And so if you use something that's too tight, it can bend that up, and so make sure that this guy is the correct size. So this is probably 3/4 or 13/16, but if you have the wrong size and you try it and it's slightly too big, you're gonna ruin this, and it's gonna be very difficult to get off unless you have another tool to get it off, which speaking from experience, that'll be important. So this is a different tire. This is a steel rim. This is a load range C tire. This guy is made to handle 50 pounds of PSI as opposed to 80, which we were just looking at. This is different too because you can actually see where the cap is, this little rubber boot here, and this guy comes out, and this is a zerk inside here, and you would hook up your grease gun right to here to add some more grease. Now, I will tell you, you're probably better off packing your bearings once a year than greasing that zerk, because what happens to 80% of the customers I've noticed is they will over grease that and blow out the back seal and ruin their backer plates and their brakes and stuff like that. And so usually 9 times out of 10 you're better off just bringing it to a place like us, having us repack it, and you'd be good to go. So there's a lot of people saying different things about how often you should repack your bearings. The general consensus is about every 5,000 to 10,000 miles and about every year or two. So usually what people do is when they have us winterize their coach, they say, hey, go ahead and repack the bearings, check the roof for problems and make sure the seals are good. A lot of times when we are checking the bearings, we can also check the brakes for you, make sure that they haven't glazed over or anything like that, and that they're all grabbing the walls evenly instead of one wheel doing all the work. Another quick tip about safety and packing the bearings is a lot of times when we pack the bearings, we'll also check the brakes too and make sure they're adjusted correctly. Some of them are auto adjusting and some of them aren't, and so that will matter. But even if they are the auto adjusting, a lot of times we will want to make sure that they are all grabbing the wheel at the same amount so that you don't have one wheel heating up compared to the others. So if you're on your trip and you happen to, when you're pulling into the gas station, feel your tires and make sure that the hubs and these all feel about the same heat wise. If one is smoking or if one feels hotter than the others, that's your problem wheel and you need to get that addressed right away. This green cap means that this tire was filled with nitrogen. That means that it's going to handle better, brake better, longer tread life, things like that. You can fill it up with normal air, it's just that you won't get those benefits. Most car dealerships nowadays are starting to carry nitrogen if you wanted to do that. Also, you can bring those little portable packs and that can make it so that you can fill up your tires at home or at your storage lot. Another thing to make sure you bring with you is a tire aid. This guy is a way to change out your tire. Now, another tool that you're gonna need is a tire iron, because this guy is usually about 13/16 or 3/4. You'll have to measure to figure it out, but it doesn't usually come with a tire iron to get the tire off. And I will also mention, a lot of times the spare tire is an option. So if you didn't get one with a spare tire, make sure you do. And a lot of times people will forget to fill their spare tire. They'll check these for and then forget their spare and then need a spare and then they're out of luck. There are three things that you can do to make sure your tires last a little bit longer. One is add some tire shine to it. I always like the kind that I can just spray on and leave on and not have to wipe off. It has some UV protectant and it will help it from cracking over time. A second thing you can do is add a tire guard. So this is basically a tire cover for the side of the coach. You have to make sure you get the correct size based on your tire and rim size. But what this does is, especially on the south side facing tires that have a lot of sun and stuff, they tend to sun rot and crack out the side well before you run out of tread. So you can avoid that by having a tire guard and let a $30 tire guard get ruined instead of a $100 tire. The third thing to protect you is the tire and wheel option coverage on our extended service policy. This is cool because it will reimburse you for charges incurred for flat tire repair needed because of road hazard. The benefit is extended also to your tow vehicle as well, which is kind of nice. It will be reimbursed not for just the tire, but also the rim as well if you needed that, and the taxes and tire and stem replacement. And that is a $0 deductible, and it's an add-on to the extended service policy that you can purchase through our shop here at the Great Outdoors. So remember, bring a torque wrench with you, bring a tire gauge with you. Make sure you check both of those things before each trip. And that's it for all the stuff that you need to know about tires and wheels on RVs and campers. Thanks for watching our video. All the parts that you saw in our video are in our parts store. We have a full parts store and service department. Both our parts and service staff are very knowledgeable and can help you troubleshoot, make recommendations on either your travel trailer, fifth wheel, motorhome, pop-up, as well as your truck that you're towing it with, as far as anything from hitches to water, electrical, you name it. The Great Outdoors RV is located in Evans, Colorado. We're just the southeast side of Greeley, right on Highway 85, about an hour north of Denver. Our address is 3511 West Service Road, Evans, Colorado 80620. Our phone number is 970-339-1997, and our web address is www.thegreatoutdoorsrv.com.